Let's talk about having directives talk to each other. So this may seem a little strange at first, so just kind of bear with me. And I'm gonna kind of gloss over some of the more advanced things in this. But if you remember how we create an element directive, we restrict it to E for element. And then I'm gonna set up something in here for the link function with element. We'll say element bind mouse over, or mouse enter. You've seen this before, function. And then we're going to log something in there. So what I'm going to do here is set up a controller for the directive, which, and this stuff will be new for this video. And this takes the typical scope. And in our controller, we're going to have kind of build an API for other directives to talk to this one. So say, for example, say this dot add strength as a function, and then we'll say scope abilities push strength. We could actually have to create that scope abilities array first. And then we'll say this.addSpeed as a function, and scope abilities push speed. And then this dot, let's do flight, add flight, scope abilities push flight. Now you may see where I'm going with this. So whenever we roll over this guy, we're just going to say console log scope dot abilities. All right, so we've set up our element directive, which wouldn't do anything right now, so I'm not going to show it in the I'll just show it real quick right here. It would just look something like this. That's all we have set up, but it wouldn't do anything. So what we can do is set up some other directives here. So we'll say this is the speed directive, or we did strength first. So let's do that. Looks like I misspelled strength up there. All right, strength, speed. All right, let's go back down here. So strength is going to return, and this is going to use the something that's new here. It's going to say require. And it's going to talk to the superhero directive. It's going to require the superhero. And what that's going to do, it's going to give us access to, in the linking function, it's going to give us access to the controller of that other directive. So scope, element, attributes, and then we can reference the superhero controller. You can name that whatever you want. It'll pick it up just because it's the fourth parameter there. So from the superhero controller, we can say superhero controller add, let's see, this one was strength. And then if we make a few copies of this, this one we'll say speed, and we'll do speed, and then flight, and scroll down a little bit. And here we'll do flight. All right, so if you can kind of see what's going on, we set up a superhero element, set up a controller that has an API of add strength, add speed, add flight. And then these other directives, which are going to be attributes, remember they default to attributes, are going to require the superhero directive, which will give us access to that controller. And then in the linking function, we'll say superhero add strength for the strength directive, add speed for the speed directive, and add flight for the flight directive. So what that would look like in here, we'll just do flight, speed, strength, and we'll say this guy's Superman. If everything went well here, once we roll over this, you'll see flight, speed, strength is what it logs out. And that's because it added each of these. It called the API add strength, add speed, add flight, and push those onto the abilities. then we log out all the abilities. Now, one gotcha here that's kind of advanced, and we'll get more into it in later videos, but I think I'll point it out now for a good measure. If I were to do this and say the flash, let's make these look a little bit different. We'll just say element add class button. This will use the button class of the foundation library. Anyway, so I made two copies to see if I roll over the flash, it'll say speed. If I roll over Superman, it's going to say speed. And this is because it hasn't created an isolate scope. An isolate scope is what it's called. Isolated the scope from other scopes. So basically all we're going to do here is say scope and pass in a new object. And that's going to say keep the scope inside of the superhero. Don't, you know, share it across. Don't inherit from other scopes. This will keep it from overriding the properties on the previous scope. So if you go roll over the flash, it'll do speed. If I roll over Superman, it'll fight speed strength. So it separates them from each other. So it's, if you're going to do things like elements or reusable directives that are going to add properties or models onto the scope, make sure to create a few of them so that you know that it's you know that they're not going to break each other. So we'll add another one to strength. We'll say the Hulk. So the Hulk should have strength, if I spell it right. The Hulk should have strength, flash speed, Superman, flight speed, strength. So hopefully that makes sense. I know I kind of threw a lot in there, but just a quick review. Again, restricting to be an element. The scope isolates it from the other directives so that, you know, those properties don't get overwritten, the abilities don't get overwritten. There's a controller property here that we can add a controller to build an API for the other directives to access using this dot whatever. So this adds strength, adds speed, add flight. This we've seen multiple times already, just linking the scope and the element and all that stuff together. And then these other directives, they're just attributes that require, that's the property reason here, the other directive that you're using, that can be any sort of directive. It doesn't have to be an element directive, it can be another attribute directive. It's something to play with if you have a free Saturday night. And just access that controller from the fourth parameter and you are all set to go.